Hello everyone, welcome or welcome back to my channel. My name is Shayla and we are checking out some solo releases from Wooji, which I'm very excited about. This has kind of been requested for me to continue on doing the like solo members from 17, their solo projects. So I've done some of Hoshi's, I've done Vernon's most recent one, and I've done June's most recent one. And so I thought like this was one that lots of people talk about, so this is one that maybe I should check out. And he just released another, I don't know if it's just released a song, just remastered a song, I don't quite know what it is, but I thought that was a good like time to do it, if that makes sense. Well, it's kind of on everyone's mind. So we are going to react first to Ruby, and then to the lyric video for What Kind of Future. Again, I was reading some of the comments just to make sure that, like, because I believe this one has to do with, unfortunately, the passing of Moonbin of last year. And so I wanted to just kind of gauge that was what this was about, and I wasn't going to be stepping on any toes by talking about it or referencing that. And I was seeing some people say that this is a different kind of version of this song, and I don't really understand why that is. Like, if this was something he released before, maybe my first thought was that it was maybe released on SoundCloud and then he actually like remastered it and put it out again, but I'm not sure. So please let me know. But that's the second song we are going to watch. The first song we are going to watch is Ruby. So, yeah, let's go.
Whoa. This outfit. Out of sight, where am I running to now? Red at night, shining lights, pulling me close. But I run, finding out, she pushed me in. Oh, oh my gosh, yeah, I see myself again. Baby girl, you're making me a beautiful jewel. Every time I look at you, I keep turning red. I'm not going back, you're calling me like you. My forbidden fruit. This is not the sound I thought we were gonna hear at all. Whoa. And the English too? These shots. Shit, this is rare too. Baby girl, you're making me a beautiful jewel. Every time I look at you, I get. Shit, this is red too. Could call me like you. My forbidden fruit. She got the ruby lips. My heart's taken away. I don't give up. My heart's come to you. I love the fashion here. Look at that suit. That's it? Oh my goodness. Wow. Okay. This was literally
I can't stress this enough. Unless he came on here and did like a screamo song, this was the farthest thing that I can possibly imagine that I thought that this song was going to be. And I don't know why, because he's really shown that he can do anything, like, just even within 17's discography, with what he's produced for other artists. Like, he's so talented in that way. But for whatever reason, this is not what I assumed he would go for in, like, a solo debut. Because this was his solo debut, as far as I can tell. Maybe I'm wrong. But this is, it just feels very, it feels, yeah, I just, I'm so surprised, but in such a good way. I don't know. I didn't see him as like this kind of like more rocky vibe, but it fits him so well. And also, like, I feel like it's a very different vibe than we get to normally see him within 17 too. It's very like loud and out there, and like the fashion is really, really interesting and fashion forward, and the shots are really artistic. Like, it's so cool. It's really, really cool when you get to see an artist's artistry, like, on full blast like this. Like, fully what they want to do because they wanted to do it, you know? And I think that that's something that I'm really seeing here. I was a little bit thrown off, especially at the beginning, with, like, the like, off-timed, like, singing with the beat. And it kind of, like, it has that kind of, like, jarring feeling throughout the song where you're like, whoa, okay, suddenly we have this jazzy-sounding piano in the bridge. Alrighty, let's go. Like, it's very, like, knocks you off your feet the entire way through, both the music video and the song, at least to me. So, yeah, I don't know. I'm very, very impressed. This is really, really cool. We're gonna watch this again. I feel like, in my opinion, the lyrics are pretty self-explanatory, but I might be missing something. There might be like a metaphor or something for Ruby that I'm not getting, but the lyrics did make me laugh. I like how, like, the little bit of swearing, how the hook has kind of the I don't give a blank, but also, like, the Coke Zero line, the constant references to red stuff. I think it was very tongue-in-cheek. I think it was really fun. So yeah. That was cool. Wow. And to have it in English as well. Very interesting. Anyways, let's watch this again and I can point out specific parts that I really enjoyed. Also, this intro, is this in the actual song? Or is it just for the music video? Hello. It's also, like, a simple but complicated music video, if that makes sense. Like, it's simple in the fact that we don't have these huge elaborate sets or dance breaks or whatever, because that's not what the song needs. But it's also, like complicated and elaborate. Maybe not complicated, but, like, elaborate in, like, the constant costume changes, the color choices, that one room where they're all, like, circling around him. Love that. Like, it's a very well shot, I feel like, and well directed music video. Oh, yeah, that. Out of sight, where am I running to now? Let it light, shine a light. I really like that part. I really like this part. This part. It's like, it's interesting too, because he is constantly talking about this girl as if she is the ruby, the gem, and stuff like that, but also that she's affecting him in a way that's turning him into that jewel, which is also kind of interesting with him in, like, the red suit and the red lighting. And I'm like, whoa, I wonder what this means, you know? Like, this is where I'm wondering if I'm missing a little bit of the context there. I'm not going back, calling me like you, my forbidden fruit. She got this shot too, which is just like him through wherever it is, him through the holes of the, in the plastic. That's such an interesting, like such a simple thing. Get a bunch of holes in like a plastic sheet and we'll shoot you through them and then also back up. But like it works so well. I don't know. Just I really like the little things they did with this music video. Also, put that away. This part.
Shit, this is rare too.
I love it so much. His face too.
Shit, this is rare too.
This in the bathtub. There's so much fashion. He looks like a vampire here. There's so much fashion stuff going on. Like, it looks like these girls are on a catwalk. I need to pick his mind about this. Yeah, this part, like a car.
Baby girl, you're making me a beautiful jewel. Every time I look at you, I keep turning red.
I guess this piano section is like the outro. And then the little laugh at the end. Oh, that was great. I really, really enjoyed that. Again, very much a surprise, but I love when I'm surprised, so. Okay, so this now we are gonna listen to is What Kind of Future? Like I said before, I believe this one has some, not some, is definitely like referencing the passing of their friend Moonbin, and I would like to let everyone know that if that's not something that you like think you can deal with right now, then feel free to click off. I might cry. I am usually quite emotional. So if that's something also you don't want to see, then maybe you don't need to be here. But I feel like it's also important to watch things like this and share them, especially because that's obviously what he wanted to do with the release or whatever of the song. So yeah. Okay, here we go.
Oh,
Okay, sorry I didn't really, like, talk at all or pause like I normally do with these kind of, like, lyric videos. I don't know, I felt like, wow, it went by very fast for a 4 minute song, but it kind of felt like, it needed to be, like, played out, and this is something that I don't really want to, like, go into, like, what I think the lyrics mean or whatever. I just think it's something that it's better just to kind of experience and not maybe speculate on exactly. But I did really enjoy that. I think the melody was beautiful. I think the production was really pretty. There was a part here which I believe would be around the bridge area. I don't remember exactly where it was though. Oh, yeah. Okay, go back here. I just really want to point out, instrumental coming in. His voice. The back of our vocals. Yeah, I just I don't know, wanted to react whatever that ends up meaning, you know, but just appreciate this this song and this release. Again, I'm sorry it wasn't really in my normal style or whatever, but I don't know. I don't know what else to say. I did really enjoy this reaction. I hope you guys did too. I'm excited to continue reacting to 17 in the future. And yeah, I really, really, really appreciate Tim for putting out these beautiful songs and for creating 17's beautiful discography as well. So, okay. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye-bye.